I can't do things like with just one hand, like my left.
It's quite hard. You're not one-handed.
You know, I'm kind of ambidextrous.
Oh, are you?
Not really, but my right hand is stronger. My left hand is more coordinated.
I kick with my left foot, and I give hand jobs with my right hand.
And then what do you give foot jobs with?
My mouth.
Okay, wait. What I was gonna say is I kick with my right foot, throw with my left hand, bat right-handed.
Wait, you? Oh yeah, because you're left-handed. Every time you write, I'm always like, you're left-handed. I was like surprised because I just am like, I'm so surprised. You know, I thought we were twins, and that one thing is different.
No, we're because we're twins, but like in the mirror.
Oh, we're mirror image twins.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. See? Oh! Not even that great of a realization. Is it on?
Yeah, it's on.
Okay. No peanut gallery, please. Thank you so much.
We have strict rules against peanut gallery comments. Hey everybody, welcome back to our hangout sesh. Haley's coming over to, hang out, so we thought we'd hang out with you guys as well. And we've got some faves, we've got some unfaves, and we got some facts to share with you guys.
True.
And,
I'm not sure if they're actually facts.
But. Yeah, we don't stand by our facts. But, what do you know? Okay, so we're going to start out with some favorites, and our first favorite is going to come to us from Haley, and it's about a Jose Marin product. So we thought we'd ease, you know, the beauty subscribers in with a beauty product.
Wait, it's Jose?
I always say Jose wait, I don't know what I say.
You always say Jose
Did
Marin.
Did I pronounce it like Jose Bank?
Joseph A. Bank. Wait, also am I always talking about this? Because Joseph A. Bank has like the most insane sales.
Yeah, three suits for $400. Buy one suit, get four free.
Buy one suit, get...
The Men's Warehouse only does like buy one suit, get
one
free.
Dude, I don't know why, but it's just like, it gets me.
Every fucking like wedding that Ryan is in, because he's the best man a lot, guys, because he has lots of friends and he's a great guy. Mm-hmm. He has to fucking rent a suit from there, and it's just like...
Oh, I didn't know they did suit rentals.
Oh yeah, that's like probably their biggest... That's why they charge so much for the suit rentals. That's why they give away 7 suits every time you buy one.
It's just so crazy, like, how is that cost?
No, but that's where you bought that rug that you... By the way, I'm a little so upset that you put that rug out on the street.
Yeah.
I would have taken it for, me HQ.
Wait, wasn't that the rug?
With the diagonals.
Oh. But it was too fuzzy. There was always these, like, crazy fuzzies.
I wanted it.
Rugs USA, like, sometimes things are full price, but probably 80% of the time, it's like...
That's the place
75% off full price rugs!
That's the place you sent me to, right? And I think I put a rug in my cart, and it was like, do you want this rug for 80% off? Like, here's the code! And I was like, that's tempting. How is
that? It makes me less... Like, makes me want to buy less from the... Anyway, okay.
Yeah, you never
Jose Marin.
Or Jose.
Or Jose Maran, if we're trying to go crazy about it.
Or Jose.
Okay, this is an argon... Wait. There.
You gotta do this. You gotta cup it.
Pardon me. YouTube. What's the word?
Etiquette. Just like known techniques.
There we go. Okay, this is Argon Infinity Cream Intensive Creamy Oil.
Ooh.
And Austin always gets mad at me because my face is so oily at night because I put it all over everything, but it smells so good.
Do up my little hairy arms. Not my whole arm. Just like
do
right
you
here.
Want to do a body?
I haven't shaved my arms in a while. You can see how I'm kind of a werewolf.
You don't need to shave your arms. Craziness. I put kind of a lot.
Let's do this like a QVC thing.
Should we look into each other's eyes?
No, like be like, now the way this lotion just rubs in, and I'm just going, it feels amazing.
QVC bloopers are like my favorite.
Oh, add a favorite to the video. We'll talk about later. Jewel TV. I fucking love Jewel TV.
I don't know what that is.
I used to come home drunk every time I went out to the bars when I lived in Philly, which was all the time because I was a party girl. And I would just watch Jewel TV for hours. And because they're all like from the South and they're just trying to sell these like chocolate diamonds and like ugly colored pearls. And it's just so good.
So it's kind of like QVC, but it's...
It's QVC, but strictly terrible jewelry. So, okay, like, I know QVC is, like, half terrible jewelry, half, like, home... Or one-fourth homewares, one-fourth, like, terrible Isaac Mizrahi collaborations.
Yeah.
Jewel TV is just all the worst jewelry in the world. The stuff you find at Costco that my dad buys me. My dad buys stuff from Jewel TV and he gives it to me for Christmas and it's always terrible.
But I thought that every kiss begins with K.
I'm so embarrassed. I only learned what that meant like a year ago.
Wait, what do you mean? There's no secret meaning to it.
Yes, there is.
Because...
Wait.
Oh my god!
Wait, wait,
so
what?
Ryan and I were sitting watching TV and I was all like, this is so stupid. Oh. Every kiss doesn't begin with K because sometimes kisses happen where people don't give jewelry to each other from K.
Wait, you mean like the literal letter K?
Yes.
Oh my god.
And so I make fun of things. I'm like, kisses start without getting jewelry given to you from that ugly K jewelers. And Ryan was like, are you fucking kidding me right now? And I was like, what? And he was like, every kiss begins with K, like the letter K. And I was just like, oh.
Wait, you know how many times I've been like, oh, like every kiss begins with K, I bet. Like the shittiest kiss is all
you were talking about the same thing, I don't know.
Okay, but that's like obviously the other meaning of
it. Kate also right now has like basically like Pandora jewelry bracelets because they're like, she loves our dogs. I can't believe she said yes. Give her these jewels to commemorate your
relationship. The Pandora, no offense if you like.
No, I've already hated on Pandora on here. Okay. Like, they know.
Wait, the charm bracelet.
No!
Wait, have you seen the like, commercial?
Get rid of those!
Throw it out the window.
I love my little notepad. It's like a good prop for like smacking things.
They'll like read the lady across the room. She'll be like, I bet she likes to vacation in Paris and she bikes on the weekends.
Weekends. And they'll
be like, how did you know that? And she'd be like, I live down
here. Pandora!
Pandora! Everything you need to know about a person right on their wrist.
Well, do you remember those Italian charm bracelets like Chopini or Gianni or Gioni?
Were these the ones that were popular in like 2000?
Yes.
Yeah.
With the charms.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, I accidentally bought a G instead of a C because I really couldn't tell the difference. So, really, I had GM on my.
It's a huge successful company.
This is when I was going to high school, so like I bought a wildcat because my high school's mascot was the wildcat. I had like.
You fully did this. This was like.
Oh, I had a bracelet full of them. But like, you know, eighth grade. That's more acceptable.
Ooh,
than
we
being,
went up a few grades, didn't we?
Well, I'm a grade above you. Actually, it might be two grades
2000
above you.
Was like.
2000, I was in sixth grade. No, 2002 is when I.
You graduated high school in 2006, right?
Yeah.
And I was seven.
Uh huh.
So 2000 was like fifth and sixth grade, right?
Yeah, I was more of a 2002. That's when they were really popular, when I was in eighth grade. That was it for my school. Anyways.
Okay, anyways, what I was just going to say quickly is that the reason I really
Oh yeah, back to the Jose Marin.
Is, it's, so it has argan oil. I know that some people are like, whatever, that's like the fifth ingredient on the list of what's in there, but, it smells really good and it has like a million uses and that's what's on the side of the box. So I was going to read you the picture I sent you
perfect.
Over text, remember?
Yeah.
Wait, it's going to take me like 10 minutes to read it, so I'll just do a couple.
Just read the whole thing.
Deeply moisturize dry areas of the face. Soothe irritated skin caused by rosacea, wind, or sunburn. Soften elbows, heels, or rough patches.
Oh, that's great.
Keep stray eyebrows in place. Smooth flyaways.
That is an interesting purpose I've never heard them talk about. Like, heels and eyebrow hairs.
Yeah, and it's gonna get better. Use as a nighttime moisturizer, prevent razor burn and irritation. Apply as a lip conditioner before lipstick. Apply over lip stain for a silky finish. Dab on eyelids before applying eyeshadow.
Oh, for like that wet look. Oil slick look.
I was going for the wet look. But apply before or after using cheek stain to improve blendability. Okay. Transform powder eyeshadow into a pigment. Oh, wait, into a cream.
Hmm.
You can mix with a powder luminizer to create a light shimmery lip balm. Ooh. Hydrate delicate skin under the eyes.
This person's really detailed, like, you
know. Highlighter
like,
on your like yeah. cheekbones. I mean, I haven't used it.
I think you need to make a video that's testing out every single one of these suggestions.
I really only used it for a nighttime moisturizer because I like to go to bed looking as oily as possible. That's my goal. I want him to be like not coming near me because I'm so oily.
Well, yeah, my hope is that I'm so slick that if he tries to grab me, I can just
slip right out of his grasp,
slip right out of his arms, and run away.
I'm gonna have to have a drink of goldfish after that one.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, so that covers that.
Oh yeah.
10 out of 10, recommend.
Yeah, it's a good present too. It's like $28, so it's like not too cheap. But not
gift
too
guide! Much. Christmas gift guide.
Yeah.
Okay, can I talk about something now? This is really important to talk about.
Okay.
It's a fave. It's my first fave on the list.
What did you discover recently?
Okay, confession. I had never really had orange juice up until like 3 years ago. This probably sounds very crazy. I'm one of those people who, when I haven't had something, I go like, oh, I don't like that. And people go like, have you tried it? And I go, no, I just know I don't like it.
Yeah, I know, I'm totally
so
like that
too. I had Sunny D as a kid, but I never really liked it. I'm drinking orange juice right now. And I fucking love orange juice. I am just all about it. Love, love, love orange juice.
Have you tried Sunny D lately, by the way?
No,
it's like, tastes like pure preservatives.
Yeah, I'm sure it's pure absolutely chemicals. Awful. Yeah, so right. I go with Simply Orange, no pulp. That's my jam. I used to juice it myself, but it's just such a hassle. Actually, I haven't made juice since I moved to San Francisco because I left the blade part of my juicer. There's like 7 different pieces. I left it in the cabinet of our house in Philly. So.
Well, it takes like 10 oranges to make like a drop of orange juice.
Yeah, because I take all the pulp out. And,
yeah.
So that's really where it all goes.
Remember anyways. When Austin and I bought a juicer? We bought a juicer.
You never used it, have you?
No, we like made juices for 3 days.
For like a good month, I made my Maroon 5 every day. Kale, beets, apples, lemons, oranges.
Maroon 5?
I called it Maroon 5 because it was maroon.
You came up with that?
Yeah!
Wow.
I'm the first person to make maroon drink Maroon 5. If only there was 5 ingredients. Oh my god, was there 5 ingredients?
Wait, I thought that's what you meant.
No, I just called it Maroon 5 because of the maroon color.
Oh, that creative. By the way, so, are you caught up on The Voice?
Yep, I am. We can talk about that in a little bit.
Okay.
So, fried eggs. Also, I never knew I liked fried eggs till about 6 months ago. And Ryan was like, have you ever had a fried egg? And I was like, no, I only like them scrambled. And then he was like, here, let me make you a fried egg. Because he was making one for himself. They're fucking delicious. I started out having like a pretty hard yolk. And now I'm into like a runny yolk. And
or medium. I like over medium.
I don't know the distinction.
Where it's like sort of runny, but not like too liquidy. So it sort of spreads, but not like to the edge of the plate.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Not like water, but like syrup.
Yolk is really kind of creepy.
Yolk is very weird, but it's quite good. So my next thing I've never ever had before is a hard-boiled egg. I want to try that. I'll report back to you guys. I'm 26 years old. It's time to live, you know?
I know where you can go get a good hard-boiled egg.
Like a deli? Any deli anywhere? They always sell them for like $1?
Wait, but aren't... Oh, shit.
Boil my own?
Oh my god, wait, I'm totally...
Your deviled egg?
I'm thinking of the wrong thing.
Poached egg?
I was thinking poached.
Oh, yeah.
Well, because...
I mean, hey, give them the wreck.
Well,
because I had a terrible poached egg at Squat and Gobble. Eggs Benedict is disgusting, by the way. That was also on my quest to open my horizons. Eggs Benedict tastes like shit.
Yeah, well, I feel like there's like Eggs Benedict people who that's all they order when they go to breakfast.
My cousin Steffi's obsessed with it. That's why I always wanted to like it. I'm like, Steffi loves it.
Yeah, and that's all I get. But I guess like the right way to poach an egg is if it's super white.
Mm.
You know, it looks like unnaturally white.
We were watching.
So Jazzy's the place I was gonna say.
Oh, yeah, okay. That's like a place people
really
talk about. I don't think I've ever been there. But we were just watching Mind of a Chef on Netflix. It's narrated by Anthony Bourdain. It's like David Chang from Momofuku. It's like a PBS thing. But he just did these eggs that he like wrapped in saran wrap and like attached to a string and like dunked them in. And then it makes these eggs that look like little buns. And they're really yummy.
That sounds so fun.
We should try it.
Wrapped in saran wrap?
Yeah. It kind of made me think like, oh, what if there's plastic and PVDs coming out? I'm so weird about like warming up and colding down plastic.
Cold that down.
Oh!
I can't believe that you just tried that because I make eggs all the time. That's like all I made in college.
My family like never ate meals together growing up. Like my mom didn't really cook.
No, it's same. Dad... So that's what we would do. We'd have eggs instead. You just like make an egg for dinner.
And I just always had scrambled eggs. But I ate like donuts for dinner because like no one paid attention to like what I was doing. And my dad owned a restaurant, and so he would bring home burgers. This is a terrible fact. My dad used to bring home burgers, but I didn't like them. I thought they tasted too charred, and I liked Burger King better. So this is such a fucking brat. I used to. Like, I didn't have an eating disorder, but I would wrap
like the
burgers. I need to preface it because what I'm going to say next describes very eating disorder-y.
Okay.
I used to break the burgers up into little pieces, wrap them in tissue paper, and hide them in my closet.
Because you felt so bad that, like, you didn't
want... I didn't like them, and they would yell at me if I didn't eat them.
Oh.
So
they wouldn't watch you eat.
No, they wouldn't. Because it would be like, here's your burger, gutting around. I'm describing a very sad childhood with my pet. I'm choking. Okay, so... I would like put them in this little jewelry box, and I left them in the jewelry box for quite a long time, and it molded the whole box. I ended up having a bag that was just full of burgers, like a shopping bag. And it was sixth grade, my family got me, I think maybe an iMac computer or something, because I was begging for one for like forever and ever and ever. And I got a purple iMac, and it was like amazing. But they went to hide the printer in my room, and my brother opened up the closet and he found a bag full of burgers. So this is like typical.
This is definitely eating disorder. This sounds like,
it gets worse. So anyways, my brother gives me my bag of burgers to me as a birthday gift.
That's good.
And like thought it was the funniest fucking thing
that
ever.
Is,
and I was like devastated they found my burger back.
So why then did you throw it out?
So then this is where I came up with my next idea.
Okay.
My next idea to get rid of the burgers was to put them into a bag and throw them over the fence to a neighbor's yard.
For the dog or something?
No, just threw them over there because it's out of sight, out of mind.
Dude, this is the kind of shit where, like, if a crime was committed, we were just talking about this, if a crime was committed and they were researching the area, what's it called?
They'd be like, looking for evidence, there's burgers everywhere.
Like, wow, like, little pieces of burger scattered all over the backyard, like, what does this mean?
Okay, so I got overzealous with it, and I guess I was throwing them into, like, the dog area of my neighbor's yard. So then I started thinking, like, I can just throw anything over the fence.
Wait, is this the first time you've told this story?
No, I've told some people. I'm not ashamed of it. It's more of like, listen how weird I was. So I started kind of just like putting trash in the bag too and throwing it over. And eventually my neighbors asked my mom for me to stop throwing stuff over
the fence. It was you.
Well, they were like, can you guys stop throwing stuff over the fence? I'm assuming it's Chelsea. Because I think there was probably like, you know, little girl stuff in there or whatever. And, well, yeah, so the dog Harley didn't die, but I'm in retrospect now, it's probably terrible. Like, it's very awful of me to throw rotten burgers into a dog's area.
I feel like at my house,
it was a really high fence. It was like 20 feet high, so I would have to like chuck it. Sometimes it wouldn't make it over and fall back down. I would have to chuck it over
the fence. You're so sick. I would like sit at the table till I finish, and I would sit. I was like, my parents made me sit there for like an hour plus. I would just be like pushing green beans around the plate.
I once ate beef bourguignon. I chewed the same piece for 4 hours because I didn't want to swallow it.
That can't be true.
It's 100% true. And guess what? I tricked them. I ended up spitting it in a plant when they weren't looking. I hate beef bourguignon, and my grandma made it.
I feel like I'm learning a whole new side of you, and I'm not sure I feel.
Well, it's like my weird picky eater thing, where it was just
I'm a picky eater too.
Well, because I'm very weird about like textures. Like first time I had sushi, I almost threw up. Like I'm very like I can't eat tomatoes because they're squishy and weird and they're hard on the outside. Like it's all completely like. Like, even if things are amazing and taste delicious, the fact that, like, something's squishy and some, like, it just throws my mouth off. So, beef bourguignon just tastes like shit, and it was, like, once you've chewed it for enough time, like, my throat will just close up and be like, not happening.
I know, I definitely get the throat closing thing.
So, it was just, like, I'm just chewing, and my friend's over at my grandma, and she was just like, just swallow it, and I was like, I can't. So, we just sat at a table for 4 years.
I was just about to make a related story that I'm just not going to share. But, no.
You can't just tease us like that. You
the government is watching this. I can't bring it up. Whatever. What I was going to say is you can imply what you want. What I was going to say is leaving it in your mouth just means you tasted more.
I know. I understand that now, but, okay.
All right.
You couldn't tell that to me.
Okay, we need to move on. Ryan's back there being listening to us saying, Jesus, you guys, we need to move on. What else? What do you want to talk about?
Well, your turn. Whatever you want to talk about.
Okay.
Speaking of oranges.
No.
Great transition.
Should we do an unfave?
Oh, yeah.
Let's do an unfave.
Which one? So many.
You want to explain your first one?
Plants.
How much she kills them.
Kill all of them. I'm going to give you some examples of the plants I kill.
No.
So, number one, I talked about this. That when I bought these from Renegade Crafter like 2 years ago, some of these are dead, some of them kind of came alive. That one's dead, that one's dead, that one's dead, but it kind of has little things growing out of it, so I don't know. Anyways, exhibit A, dead plants.
But the thing that annoys me about succulents is I kept thinking that they're so easy to care for, but mine keep dying.
Exhibit B, I bought these plants at Molly Stone's and they didn't even open and they died. Like, what the fuck? They're in water. Like, what the fuck? I can't believe I paid $16 for 3 peonies, but I was just so excited to see peonies. So, exhibit B.
Wait. We're facing east, right?
I don't know. Exhibit C. My dad gave me these for my birthday in August, and they're already dead. How the fuck do you keep orchids alive?
Well, I mean, August is a long time.
Actually, that's the longest I've ever kept anything alive. These died
And orchids die, like, they're famous
2 weeks
dying.
Ago. Okay, this right here,
There's another dead orchid.
My apartment just seems like it's full of dead plants.
This is where plants come to die.
This is, yeah. This orchid, dead, it was given to me in September? Maybe July? I don't know, but dead.
Super necessary to dead. Know exactly when you got it.
But I can show you that I had it on a ledge, and these bowls were next to it, and the dead petals just fall into the thing. So it kind of looks nice, like...
Fantastic.
You know, oh, look at those nice little petals, but no. So, anybody got any advice for me? I'll gladly take it. Plants are hard to keep alive, man.
Well,
I can keep a dog alive, but I can't keep a fucking plant alive.
I was actually just going to make that connection.
Yeah. People are like, I can't even keep plants alive. How am I supposed to have a baby? And it's like, I think babies are actually far easier than orchids. Just throw it out there.
Well, I feel like every plant should come with instructions, which I guess sometimes they do, but
sometimes
not enough.
Sometimes they do, but they're not, like, water it a little bit every 2 weeks. It did it. It still died.
2 weeks?
Orchids are, like, supposed to be, like, 2 weeks. Like, my my grandma's kind of like an orchid whisperer, but I think it's just that she has a really good, like, mantle where they survive. Like, I don't know if it really has anything to do with her, but she was saying, I put an ice cube in it, and, like, that's the perfect amount of water to give it.
Well, it depends on the size of the plant.
I mean, a regular orchid.
And the size of the ice cube.
Giant ice cube, tiny plant. Best mix.
Okay. I really love, like, angora rabbits.
Yes.
Have you seen these?
I love wearing them.
Okay, well, I'm not going to let you near the chinchilla I met last week. You know it takes 1,000 chinchillas to make a coat?
And chinchillas are that quite smart animals, so boycott chinchilla always and forever.
Do you want to see
even if it's vintage.
Did I send you the picture of the chinchilla I met the other day?
No.
I'll show it to you, everybody here. So I went to a pet store...
Don't go to pet stores. They're all, like, inbred from breeders and fall.
Don't ruin this for me.
I burped.
Wait, look at him.
I burped again.
Look.
It's my orange juice coming up. Oh, hi, little mouse.
Apparently it takes, like, you know... Wait.
You gotta, like, tilt it at an angle to release the shadow or the
reflection. Look it.
Yeah.
It's really, really, really sad they make those into coats, but I get why, because they're so soft. Don't quote me on that. Oh, fluffy chickens. Bantam chickens. This is my Instagram profile picture, right? It's a bantam chicken.
Did you just change it?
It's been a bantam chicken for years.
Mine's a cat.
Oh my god.
We don't have humans as our Instagram profile pics.
Wait, I'm gonna search it and throw it up.
I think I know this. For some reason, I imagine it being this one picture of you with, like, black jeans with, like, holes in them in front of, like, the gazebo sort of.
I can see how you'd mix that up with a bantam chicken.
You know, because you look like a bantam chicken in them.
Yeah, I mean, well, that's, like, the ultimate
Where's
goal.
Where's my phone? Maybe I can pull it up.
What, my Instagram picture?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm on Instagram.
Wait. Look it. Wait, and the best part?
Oh, yeah, it is this chicken. Yeah. For some reason, I always imagined it, like, I just never, like, acknowledged that it was a chicken. I imagined it being, like, a furry coat or something.
Look, see, that's my picture. Oh,
I can tell you went to this thing with your siblings.
Yeah. I know pet stores are terrible, but it's fun. Anyway, I read somewhere that bantam chickens are kind of like house cats. Like, they definitely, like, they can live indoors. Actually, I don't know if that's true, but they can hang out indoors, and they'll, like, sit on your lap, and they're super cuddly and nice, and they're just like cats.
I wouldn't own one unless I needed to have, like chickens or something. Like, oh, if I have, like, a house someday that's kind of secluded. Makes sense.
Maybe
get the
have
eggs. I wish I had glasses to pull down, too. I was very compelled to. I could put mine on, and we could be, like, super twins. My Warbies with no prescription lens. Because I don't need glasses.
Are you sure you don't? I feel like everybody, like, does eventually. Most people do eventually.
Well, maybe if I wear my non-prescription enough, it'll screw up my eyes.
No, you have to wear, like, the incorrect prescription. And then it messes up your eyes.
I used to wear my friend's glasses when I was younger because I was just so jealous. I just wanted glasses so fucking bad. And then their moms would be like, take those off. And I'd be like, I've been wearing them for 5 hours. Like, don't you have a headache? And I was like, can't really see anything.
It does give you a headache to wear the wrong glasses.
Yeah, it does.
I'm glad that I have a
lot. I wear my mom's, and hers are, if I look in the distance, I'm like, bull, I can't see anything. But if I look at my phone, like, it's magnified twice as big. And I'm like, ooh, this is cool.
Wait, does your mom have the, like, magnified text on her iPhone?
No, she actually doesn't. My dad does it on his phone, though.
Wait. Oh, shit.
My mom has a 6, so it's already, like, pretty big.
Wait, my mom's...
She just got her first iPhone.
She had a flip phone up until like a couple months ago. Now
did
we
see
can
the
text.
Picture of like Rihanna has a razor? Like now.
That's what my mom had. Like it was a better razor.
That's so funny. My mom's text is like, it shows like 2 words per screen.
Yeah, that's what my dad's like. He doesn't ever respond to anything either. It's terrible.
It's so funny. Okay, let's talk about chokers.
Oh, I have this choker I really like. I got it from, I think there's an origin story that comes from YouTube. I think that the Persian babe, Barbara, had this choker from ASOS, and I saw it, and I loved
it. ASOS?
Am I just pronouncing everything like foreign?
Wait, it's as seen on screen, but that doesn't matter. It's
ASOS or ASOS?
I say ASOS, but I totally am probably wrong.
I mean, I can't tell because I've watched so many British people and they pronounce like Adidas is Adidas and things. They say Adidas.
All day.
And Nike instead of Nike. So I'm like off with all brand names. Like
they say what?
They say Nike. Like I got some Nike trainers. I got some Adidas trainers and some Nike trainers.
No way. That's kind of
crazy.
Fun. I think it is ASOS. I remember
so anyways,
one time that I said it.
Choker, whoop whoop. The brand.
Really, it's great. I love that.
You know what's hilarious is I think this might be just female, which is a brand that I now carry in Anno Me.
Not carrying this. You're just.
No, I bought that like 4 or 5 years ago.
Oh.
Yeah.
And you just busted it out again.
And I've just been wearing it like in the past year where I've been like, okay.
Do I have a fat neck?
No. It's a weird thing, the way you put it on. Okay, no. You have to go like, stop. I don't want to hurt you. But you, like, I go, like...
I think I kind of do, like, I have...
It's like you go in from the side.
Oh.
Like, you kind of have to, like, pull it apart and go in from the side.
I was about to go, like,
it kind of hurts.
My diary about this, but...
Like, all right, my neck's so fat.
I think I actually
and then
do.
You know,
have, like,
can I show the choke? So
it
the
looks
choke
great with, like, this t-shirt. It's, like,
yeah, there
it's
you
a
go,
nice,
part.
Like, contrast.
It's good.
Shitty and...
Love a good choke.
Yeah, it's nice.
Choker. I barely know her.
Stop.
Thanks. Give it back.
Okay. I do love that. And have you seen the people wearing like the 90s ones? Obviously.
I'm not about the braided one. Don't ever bring that
it's
back.
It's a little too, because I feel like when you reinterpret fashions, it has to be a little different.
Uh-huh.
And it's just, it's taking it too literal.
Definitely is.
I don't know about those.
Spelled your goldfish.
Oh, wait, where? Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
That's one of the things. I should get a pen so we can cross off the stuff. I have the old version.
Oh,
because you know, I got it like before it was like so fucking popular. Just kidding. Look at that, my dent in it. I'm almost hitting pan.
Wait, I hit pan on mine.
Ew, you're using too much.
Wait, I've never.
I wear it every single day.
Wait, how long have you had it?
2 years,
maybe? Oh my god, what? Am I using it too much?
No, maybe my.
Wait, mine's
well,
smaller. Mine's way smaller. Whatever, I'm just gonna keep telling myself that. So this is.
I actually think it is. It's like, isn't it more rectangular?
Mine's definitely smaller than this.
Yeah.
Well, I also okay. Cut all that out. Mm-hmm. This is the Kemno Kwan sculpting powder, which I think I knew about because of you.
Maybe.
I did. That's how I found out about it. And I was really scared to use it at first because I don't know. I feel like doing shadows on your own face is really scary.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
I'm really surprised at, like, the number of laymen, you know, regular folks who aren't beauty junkies, or people who are beauty junkies but not, like, I don't know a lot of stuff about it, just, like, buying stuff at Bath & Body Works, but they're, like, afraid to, they're afraid to contour their face, or, like,
yeah.
Something about it, like, scares them. I gave that to all my cousins for Christmas one year, because, like, what I like, I have, 3 cousins on my mom's side, girls that are all within a couple of years of me. I'm the oldest one, but so every Christmas I'll give them like the Naked palette and like Dior Amber Diamond. Like I try to pick like the best item from like
it's
YouTube
so nice.
Of the year and like give it to them. And so I gave them Kemno Kwan, but I don't know if any of them use it. I don't know if they do because I never like did like the tutorial and gave them the exact brush to use. But I figure it's kind of, I mean I literally just put it on like blush. And I don't even put it, like, deep in the hollows of my cheek. I put it kind of higher up.
I put it below my cheekbone, for sure.
I literally, like, put it, and then I put my blush, like, a centimeter higher. And they kind of just mix together.
Yeah. I mean, so, anyway, I had my 2 cousins, my sister and my mom, and my aunt were all together for Thanksgiving. And I put it on my sister. And everybody was like, oh, my God, put that on me, too. And then my sister was like, oh, my God, can you contour my whole body? Like, it looks so much better. And then, like, every night that whole weekend, everyone would line
to
up
contour
for me
your
to
body,
do it.
You have to wear that, like, Stella McCartney dress that's, like, a body shape, like a...
Oh.
Low class?
the giant oversized t-shirts that have like a busty girl in a bikini that when you wear it you look like you're that person. High
you
class.
You look exactly like
Stella McCartney dresses, or you know, they're really popular now, so lots of people are making them where they make it like Gwyneth Paltrow wore one to like Oscars like maybe 2 years ago or something, I think. But where it's like a really thin, like curvaceous body, and then it's black on all the outer part. So the dress makes you look like thinner and curvaceous the way that the seams and everything go.
Yeah.
So that's the high class version of the oversized beach bikini top. Just throwing that out there.
So that's like Kevin O'Connor for the body.
Yeah.
Anyway, so everybody was like, send me the link for this. I'm getting it. How have I gone this long without contouring my cheekbones? It does. It really
everything
was like, it works.
I feel so bloated without it.
Yeah. You need to go.
Yeah.
If you fuck it up, it's bad. I'm just gonna say that.
Yeah. I like to overdo it. I'm a big fan of overdoing it on your blush and your contour.
Yep, yeah. Well, you're good at makeup. You're better.
I'm not that good. I mean, no, self-taught. Terrible. Okay, we got that thing out the door. Here's an unfave. I like this sweater, but I took it to the dry cleaner and I think it kind of smells weird.
Let me smell.
It smells like sweaty, right?
Oh, it smells like my grandparents.
Like, what the fuck?
I think that might have been an insult. My grandma just went blind in one of her eyes.
Aww. Isn't that so sad? Or just randomly.
I don't know. She's always stumping doctors with her health concerns.
My life. Ooh. Yeah, so I think it kind of smells weird.
Oh, that's what this means? You got a dry clean?
Yeah, my dry cleaner does like staples, and they're very hard to get these tags off.
I saw one of your Alexander Wang tanks that had a tag on it also.
Yeah, that one I had just taken to the dry cleaners.
Before you even wore it?
No, it didn't have tags on it. Some of them I have tags on, some of them I have already worn.
This is a great sweater, though.
It's good, right? You want to try it on?
It kind of smells like maple syrup.
I think it's weird, right?
I'm not that mad about it, honestly.
So I'm not that into it. Smells funkaroo. But this sweater, I already took the laundress, that like fancy company, I took my wool and cashmere spray and sprayed it up, it smelled like cedar, and it smells like this now.
I'm not mad about it, that's all I'm going to say.
I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of it, so that's my thing that I'm unhappy about. I don't know, that was weird.